This video is an in-depth look at the new connected storyline feature, now available in Final Cut Pro 10.7. The new collapse to connected storyline is a benefit for editing complex timelines by visually tidying up the timeline so it's not confusing. But what else does it do? The new feature gives the ability to group a selection of clips connected to the main storyline, even though they might overlap and not be contiguous to each other. So this means that any gaps are maintained between the clips. You've always been able to add clips to a simple storyline, selecting them and using the Command plus G shortcut or clip menu, Create Storyline. But the big difference is that a simple storyline can't be created with overlapping or non-contiguous clips. And an added benefit to the new collapse to storyline, it will also group into a storyline clips that are currently independent as well as those previously grouped in another secondary storyline. Clips grouped together with the collapse to connected storyline feature are able to be moved as a single item or copy and pasted elsewhere. And if you hadn't realized, the advantage of a connected secondary storyline means that when you want to adjust the length of one clip in the storyline, the others move as if it were a magnetic storyline. So if you cut a clip using Command plus right square bracket, the clip on the left is shortened, but the two clips stay together, just as a magnetic storyline should do. Prior to version 10.7, if the connected clips overlapped, they needed to be trimmed so that they were not overlapping before they could be grouped together. The new feature overcomes that. And if you're confused, you can better understand what the collapse to connected storyline feature is by thinking of it as grouping clips and automatically trimming any overlaps, as well as maintaining any gaps between non-contiguous clips. Simple as that. So this is how to do it. Select the connected clips that you want to group together, even though they might overlap each other. Right-click and select Collapse to Connected Storyline. The overlaps are trimmed and the whole timeline is now much tidier and easier to work with. Notice though, in the drop-down menu, there's no default keyboard shortcut. I'll show you as a bonus at the end of this video how you can add your own shortcut. Added to the ability to group the clips that are next to each other, the Collapse to Connected Storyline feature also maintains any gaps between clips and includes those gap clips in the newly created storyline, and this will maintain the timing while still allowing the visibility to the clips that are in the main storyline that's below the new connected storyline. And if you try to ungroup the connected storyline with the break apart clip items from the clip menu, any clips that were previously overlapping will still stay trimmed. But that shouldn't be a problem to you. But if you do want to go back to how the clips were originally placed, that's including the overlaps, you'll need to use the undo command, that's Command plus Z. And a special note, do not include titles in the group of clips that you intend to use the new storyline feature. The title will be treated as a video clip and will trim the clip below the title. And this is the bonus I mentioned on how to add a keyboard shortcut. Open the Final Cut Pro menu and select Command Sets. Select Customize. Search for Collapse. Just type COLL in the field. And you'll see at the top of the list, Collapse to Connected Storyline has no keyboard shortcut. So let's use the C key with the Option modifier. Select Option in the top tabs, and you'll see the C in the keyboard layout is grey. This means there's no action attached to it. Drag the Collapse to Connected Storyline inside that C key. The key will turn blue. And now you'll see that the shortcut is next to Collapse to Connected Storyline. Let's use the shortcut. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and press the bell so that you'll be notified when I publish the next video about the 10.7 upgrade, which is the changes to roles and how they can now be applied to video as well as audio. Thanks for watching.